A Berkeley boy, born and raised in California, finds himself living in Detroit, Michigan, a city he has no affiliation with. However, due to his positive attitude, his competitive nature, his grit, and his charity, he has fully embraced the Motor City. They've fully embraced him as well. This is the story of Jared Goff, quarterback of the Detroit Lions.
What is the message that you want to leave with Lions fans today?
Yeah, I'm gonna give them everything I got every day. I'm gonna come in here and give them everything I got, and then Sundays, you know, hopefully we can see that show up. And I think in my brief time here, I've learned about the city, I've learned about downtown, I've learned about the history of the city and how badly they want to win and how badly they want to, you know, win big games and do that at a high level. And I think I can bring that.
It all started in Novato, California, a small town in Marin County, California, with a population of around 53,000 people. Two of those people were Jerry and Nancy Goff, Jared's parents. Jerry Goff is a former professional baseball catcher who played for the MLB on the Montreal Expos, Pittsburgh Pirates, and the Houston Astros. His professional career lasted from 1990 to 1996. In the middle of that career, on October 14th, 1994, Jared Goff was born. Born with an enzyme deficiency, which doesn't allow his body to break down proteins, among the difficulties it creates is an inability to process red meat. So Jared Goff, I'm just gonna call him Goff from now on. Goff grew up a University of California and San Francisco 49ers fan, and actually wears number 16 as a tribute to Joe Montana.
He used to hang out at Cal. He would hang out in the tunnels, and
Deshaun
Jackson would throw him gloves and any memorabilia he could get, a wristband that would, it's all smelly, you know.
He attended Marin Catholic High School in Kentfield, California, and graduated in 2013. Obviously, he played quarterback for their football team for three varsity seasons, throwing for 7,687 yards and 93 touchdowns with 18 interceptions.
I played in an area that wasn't very highly recruited, I guess you would say, just north of San Francisco, probably 30 minutes, and just didn't get college coaches a lot. We didn't have any lights in our leagues. We played on Saturdays, as did the colleges, right? So
they wouldn't
come see us as much. And
with Goff at the helm, Marin Catholic had a 39-4 record and a 21-0 Marin County Athletic League mark on their way to an appearance in the state title game, one North Coast section crown, and three MCAL championships. Needless to say, he did pretty well playing high school football. Goff was recruited by a number of college programs and received scholarship offers from Boise State, Fresno State, and Washington State, before choosing to attend the University of California, Berkeley.
Berkeley.
The school he grew up loving and the school that both of his parents attended.
So for me, being in California, I wanted to play in the Pac-12. And then specifically, I liked Cal, Stanford, USC, UCLA. One of those four in California, great schools.
He was a mid-year enrollee at Cal in January 2013, and joined the Golden Bears for the 2013 spring practices. In August, he was named starting quarterback for the 2013 season over redshirt freshman quarterback Zach Klein, becoming the first true freshman quarterback in Cal history to start a season opener. Now, during his time with the Golden Bears, Goff set 26 University of California records. This included passing yards per game, touchdown passes, completions, passing attempts, total offense, and total plays. He is second only to Aaron Rodgers on Cal's all-time list for passing efficiency. It didn't start off well, though. Under new head coach Sonny Dykes, in his 2013 season, the Golden Bears went 1-11. Goff had 18 touchdowns and 10 interceptions. And in that season, they lost to Stanford 63-13.
hard experience. We went 1-11, really hard, not fun. Hometown, you know, all my friends and family are coming to every game. We're losing every game. We won the second game of the year and then lost the rest of them.
But after that 1-11 season, Goff was more determined and became the ultimate worker bee. He studied film from Aaron Rodgers and immersed himself in all things Peyton Manning. In his 2014 season, Goff helped lead the Golden Bears to a 5-win, 7-loss season. In a September 27th matchup against the Colorado Buffaloes, Goff threw a career-high 7 touchdown passes, completing 24 of 42 passes for 458 yards. On October 4th, Goff threw for a new career-high and school record 527 yards and 5 touchdowns in a 60-59 victory over Washington State. He finished the 2014 season with 3,973 yards, 35 touchdowns, and a 62% completion rate, once again setting new school records. And finally, in the 2015 season, Goff led the Bears to a 7-win, 5-loss regular season finish, clinching Cal's first winning season since 2011. And going into that season, Goff was projected as a top quarterback for the 2016 NFL Draft. On November 14th, 2015, Goff threw for 453 yards and 6 touchdowns in a 54-24 victory over Oregon State, earning Pac-12 Offensive Player of the Week honors for the first time. 2 weeks later, Goff set a new Cal single-game record with 542 passing yards in a 48-46 come-from-behind victory over Arizona State, earning Player of the Week honors for a second time. Now, the Golden Bears did make a bowl appearance. It was the 2015 Armed Forces Bowl. Through for 6 touchdown passes and 467 yards, leading the Bears to a 55-36 victory over Air Force. After that, he earned first-team All-Pac-12 honors. He was the first Cal quarterback to earn first-team All-Pac-12 honors since Aaron Rodgers in 2004, while leading an 8-5 Cal team to a winning record and bowl game for the first time since 2011, as well as a postseason win for the first time since 2008. As impressive as that is, during Goff's time as quarterback, the Golden Bears never beat an in-state rival, going 0-9 against Stanford, UCLA, and USC. And they also went 0-3 against rival Oregon. Goff's father, Jerry, has been quoted as saying, "The lack of a marquee win bothered his son."
Okay, so after much deliberation with my family and close friends, I decided to forego my senior year at Cal and declare for the 2016 NFL Draft.
After his junior season, Goff announced his decision to forego his senior year and enter the 2016 NFL Draft.
With the first pick in the 2016 NFL Draft, the Los Angeles Rams select Jared Goff, quarterback, California.
Goff was selected first overall by the Los Angeles Rams in the 2016 NFL Draft. He got to stay in California.
Think about even off the field. This is a California kid. This is a kid that the city of LA is going to fall in love with. This is a West Coast kid. He loves California.
The Rams had traded up in the first round and acquired the first pick from the Tennessee Titans.
Being close to home was cool. It was cool. I was able to have a lot of family come. Still, it's a 6-hour drive,
yeah,
and an hour flight. But still, yeah, being on the West Coast was helpful.
On June 9th, 2016, Goff signed a four-year deal worth $27.9 million in guaranteed money. And on November 15th, 2016, Goff was named the Rams' starting quarterback for the game against the Miami Dolphins after spending the first nine games as a backup to veteran quarterback Case Keenum. Goff started the final seven games of the season, and on November 20th, 2016, he made his professional debut and first NFL start against the Miami Dolphins and completed 17 of 31 attempts for 134 yards in the 14-10 loss. The Rams would lose the last seven games with Goff as the starter. Under head coach Jeff Fisher, the Rams finished the 2016 season with a 4-12 record. Goff completed 112 of 205 passes for 1,089 yards, 5 touchdowns, and 7 interceptions. So 2016 was definitely a struggle for Goff and the Rams.
It's just hard, and I know they see it. I mean, it's hard in the locker room. It's hard for all of us, but I promise you guys it will get fixed. Everything in my heart and soul to get it all fixed.
However, Goff entered the 2017 season with new head coach Sean McVay.
We're going to be committed to our process, and we're going to be committed to a standard of performance. And those things are going to be focused on daily improvement and daily excellence. And that's what's going to help guide us on our journey to try to achieve a world championship and bring it to this great city of Los Angeles.
Under Sean McVay's coaching and guidance, Jared Goff's second season with the Rams was much improved. The Rams won 11 games and had 5 losses. And Goff finished his second professional season with 3,804 passing yards, 28 touchdowns, and 7 interceptions to go along with 51 rushing yards and a touchdown in 15 games and starts. He led the league in yards per pass completion with 12.9. On January 6, 2018, Goff played in his first playoff game. He completed 24 of 45 passes for 259 yards and a touchdown in a 26-13 wildcard round loss to the Atlanta Falcons. Now, the Rams went further in 2018, going 13-3, and Goff started the 2018 season throwing for 233 yards and 2 touchdowns in a 33-13 road victory over the Oakland Raiders in the season opener, followed by back-to-back 354-yard games and wins over the Arizona Cardinals and the crosstown rival, the Los Angeles Chargers. In the Chargers game, he also had a career-best 80.5% completion percentage on 29 of 36 passing for 3 touchdowns and 1 interception. During a Week 4 38-31 victory over the Minnesota Vikings, Goff completed 26 of 33 passes for a career high 465 yards and 5 touchdowns, finishing with a perfect quarterback rating of 158.3. Goff was named the NFC Offensive Player of the Week for his performance. Goff was later named the NFC Offensive Player of the Month for September. Against the Kansas City Chiefs in Week 11, Goff threw for over 400 yards and 4 touchdowns as the Rams defeated the Chiefs 54-51 on Monday Night Football. That was the third highest scoring NFL game in history. Now, that was the most insane football game I think I've ever seen. Now, I can sit here and just read stats of every game, but I don't want to do that. The point is, Jared Goff was excelling in the NFL. He finished the 2018 regular season with 4,688 passing yards, 32 touchdowns, and 12 interceptions. The 2018 season ended when McVay and Goff went head-to-head with arguably the best duo of coaching and quarterback in NFL history, Bill Belichick and Tom Brady, in Super Bowl 53. We'll be right back. Now at this point, the Rams offense was touted as the best in the league. However, Bill Belichick's defensive genius was able to hold the Rams offense to just one field goal. The Patriots were able to defeat the Rams the old-fashioned way, by out-hitting, outsmarting, and outworking them. The Rams and Goff faced a disappointing loss. Goff completed 19 of 38 passes for 229 yards and threw a costly interception to Stephon Gilmore late in the fourth quarter of the 13-3 loss. And the Rams tied the 1971 Dolphins for the fewest points in Super Bowl history in this loss.
Well, the toughest loss I've ever had. I mean, it kills. It's terrible, and there are some good things you can take from it, but right now there's nothing.
Now after that, things started to slide for Jared Goff and the Los Angeles Rams. The Rams finished their 2019 season 9-7, where Goff threw 22 touchdowns and 16 interceptions. His 394 pass completions did, however, set a single season franchise record at the time. During the 2020 season opener against the Dallas Cowboys, the first ever football game to be played in SoFi Stadium, Goff finished with 275 passing yards and an interception as the Rams won 20-17. Goff finished the 2020 season with 3,952 passing yards, 20 touchdowns, and 13 interceptions. Now, under the surface of all this, drama and tension was starting to brew between Jared Goff and head coach Sean McVay. At some point, amid the inconsistent season, sources said McVay contemplated whether the Rams would be able to return to the Super Bowl with Goff as the quarterback. Tension with Goff had grown. On the sideline, McVay would routinely yell at his quarterback, but some notice there came a point when McVay wouldn't circle back to apologize. Some chalked it up to the competitive environment. Others said McVay was unable to hide his frustration with Goff. For Goff, it became increasingly difficult how often his coach took aim at him, whether on the sideline, in meetings, or the practice field. A league source said Sean lost touch with how much he was breaking Jared down, but there's got to be the build back up. He was either unaware or disinterested in protecting Jared's confidence. And also during this time, a lot of people were asking if Jared Goff is an elite quarterback and if he's worth the money that he's getting paid. They were starting to suspect that all of Goff's success comes from McVay's offensive schemes. Now, despite all that, the Rams did make the playoffs. In the divisional round against the Green Bay Packers, Goff completed 21 of 27 passes for 174 yards and a touchdown in the 32-18 road loss. After that, Sean McVay and the Los Angeles Rams decided to part ways with Jared Goff. Jared Goff was coming to Detroit.